Okay, let us continue our lecture. You would like to continue the topic of arc length in the function for parameters. So, as I told you before, that we have already get the formula for arc length for the arc length for Cartesian coordinate. Now we are using the book of Sullivan and Miranda to find the arc length for parameter function. As a brief of our lecture, if the parameter function x is the function of t and the y is also a function of t, the t between a and b, then the arc length s is equal to the integral from a to b of the root square of the dx dt square plus dy dt square dt. As illustration here, if we have this function of parameters, this is the x-axis and this is the y-axis, and the curve of the parametric function is just the blue one. It's just the blue one, the blue curve. How to find this formula? By using definite integral. Of course, first we have to make a partition. Partition between a and b, for instance, t0, t1, t2, t3, ti-1, ti, tn-1 until b, where the a here is equal to t0 and the b here is equal to tn. If we take the length delta t a equal, that is the b minus a divided by n, then actually we have the number or the point p0, p1, p2 until pn, which is on the curve here, it is the point 0, point 1, point 2 until pn. And then we take the distance between the pi, between the pi minus 1 until pi, it is called the d, the distance between pi minus 1 and pi, and then we take the sigma. This sigma can be used to approach the length of the curve or the arc. Of course, here by using the distance, the distance between pi minus 1 pi is, as usual, this is usual metric, usual distance, the root square of the xti minus xti square plus vti minus vti square. And altogether, if we take the sigma, and we have this one. This expression is actually the SPF, the sum, depending on the partition P and the function of parameters, in the definition of definite integral. But how to find this one? As you see, to find this square and that square, because the x is a function of t and the y a function of t, then we use calculus 1, namely as before, mean value theorems. By using mean value theorem, then we take the following. Yeah, of course, here we can see that the sigma of the metric here, the sigma of the distance of the metric is equal to this one, delta t. This is called Riemann sum or SPF in definite integral. The sum are not Riemann sum since the number ui and nv are not necessarily equal. Yeah, but it is SPF. You see here, if this sum if we take this sum as the limit, here we use the mean value theorems, of course, and by using the mean value theorem we have this number as before, and then just by substituting the just by using the substitution from this equation that we get from the mean value theorems as before, then we have this sum. And if we take the limit, if we take the limit for the n tend to infinite or the norm of the partition tend to zero, then we have that this sum become this integral. That means the S is equal to the integral AB square root square of the dx dt square plus dy dt square dt. Actually, it is not the delta t tend to zero, but the maximum delta t I tend to zero. It also implies that the n tend to infinite. So that by using this description, we can conclude that for the graphic or the arc that given in parameter function, then the arc length of the parametric function is equal to S equal to integral AB root square of the dx dt square plus dy dt square dt. This is our second formula. For example, if we have the function xt in parametric function is equal to t power 3 plus 2, and the yt is equal to 2t power 9 divided by 2, from t is equal to 1 until t is equal to 3, just like here, then what is the length of this arc? The answer is by using the parametric formula. Of course, by using the derivative, we have to find the dx dt, dy dt, where the dx dt is equal to 3 t power 2. This coming from the 3 t power 2. And the dy dt is, of course, equal to the 2 times 9 divided by 2 by 2 t times 9 divided by 2 minus 1. If we count, we have the 9 times t power 7 power divided by 2, where the t lies between 1 and 3. So altogether, we are using the formula of parametric function for r length is S equal to the integral from 1 till 3, from 1 till 3, of the square roots of the 3t square, because this dx dt square, plus 9t power 7 divided by 2 square dt. Just by using a simple calculation, we can take it out, the t square, so we have the 3t square, the square root of 1 plus 90 power 3. And by using the definite integral, we can count by using substitution, the u. is equal to 1 plus 90 power 3, then we have the du is like this, just like this, and so on, equivalently like this, yes, and then substitute to the original integral, so this integral become the integral from 10 until 244, because it is from here and from here, because we substitute the t to u, so the bound of the integration from t become the bound to u, the u is from 10 until 244, the square of u du divided by 9. This is very easy, and then it is equal to this number. This is not very good number, but anyway, the number itself is not very important, but the most important thing is that the use of the formula that can be done in this example. Okay, the second example for the parametric function, this is very famous function, it is called a cycloid. As you know that the cycloid is given by the xt is equal to a times t minus sin t, and the yt is equal to a times 1 cos t, where the a is non-negative, and also the t actually between 0 until 2.5, between 0 until 2.5. Yeah, because this is actually a circle sliding to the right side one time. And what is the length of this curve? Which is, this curve is actually the curve of cycloid. Here the answer. From the parametric function, we have that the dx dt is equal to a times 1 minus cos t, and the dy dt is a sin t. So altogether, the s, the arc length of the parametric cycloid function, is equal to the integral from 0 until 2.5. Why? Because the restriction of the cycloid is from 0 until 2.5. So the integral is the integral from 0 to 5 root square of this square, that is this square, and a sin t square. And by using the formula of sin square t and also cos square t, we have that this is 1 minus 2 cos t plus cos square t. Yeah. And because cos square t plus square plus sin square t is equal to 1, then it is equal to the a, is the a integral 0 until 2 pi, square root of 1 minus 2 cos t plus 1. 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. So this is the square of 2 a, the integral of 0, the integral from 0 until 2 pi, the square root of 1 minus cos t. If we count this number by using the definite integral, then we have that the s is equal to square 2 times a integral 0 until 2 pi, the square root of 1 minus cos t dt. So by using simple calculation, we just have this one because we have this equation. So altogether, we have 8 times a. In conclusion, we have actually formula that the cycloid x is equal to a t minus in t, y t is equal to a times 1 minus cos t. What is the length of this curve? The length is actually is equal to 8 times a. this is also become a formula of the length or the length of the arc of the parametric function of cycloid. Here we have the proof of the formula in our lecture note in Bahasa Indonesia. I don't want to take in detail because we already have in our lecture notes the same formula. So this is the exercise. I don't want to go in exercise later on. Now I want to go to the arc length in polar coordinate. Okay, let's go to the formula. How to find the formula? Well, the formula of arc length in polar coordinate. In Bahasa Indonesia, it is called in koordinat kutub. The situation is just like this. If we have the function from alpha beta, the function is f from alpha beta angle. And this is the angle from angle alpha beta to r, with r is equal to f theta. Yes, the alpha and beta are constant, and the graph is just the blue one between the theta is equal to alpha and theta is equal to beta. So the question is, what is the length of this curve, this arc? What is the length of this arc in polar coordinate? The answer is the following. If we look at the brief formula, I mean, actually we get the formula that the arc length of the polar coordinate is equal to the S, the integral alpha beta square root of R square, where the R is equal to F theta, plus dr d theta square d theta. How to find this formula? Of course, there are some proof for that, but the most usual proof is that we consider that the polar coordinate as a parametric function, and then we can prove this formula. Once again, the function of polar coordinate can be viewed as a parametric function. Here we are. So we can find the formula of arc length in polar equation or polar coordinates just by considering that the function is as parametric function. How can we can do that? We can see that the x is equal to r cos, the connection between the x and the polar coordinate is just like this. It is in calculus 1. X is equal to r cos theta, and the y is equal to r sin theta, but the r is equal to f theta. So this is actually the multiplication function f theta cos theta. We have the shape, the y theta is equal to r sin theta, because the r is equal to f theta, then it is equal to f theta sin theta. So we can consider that the polar coordinate equation can be viewed as the x is equal to f theta cos theta as parametric function with respect to theta, and the y also parametric function f theta sin theta with respect to theta. And then we use the formula for the parametric function replaced by polar coordinate. The following. Here we have that the dx d theta, it is actually the multiplication of two function f theta and cos theta. So that by using calculus 1, we have that the dx d theta is equal to f theta, yeah, and time the derivative of cos theta, that is minus sin theta. So that is minus f theta sin theta. And secondly, plus f prime theta cos theta. And the derivative dt is equal to f theta cos theta plus f prime theta sin theta. And then we use the formula of arc length for parametric equation replaced by this dx d theta dy d theta. So we have to make it square dx d theta square plus dy d theta square. This square plus this square. Okay. If we calculate this square plus this square, then we have f theta square plus f prime theta square. It is equal to r square plus dr d theta square. Why? Because cos square theta plus sin square theta is equal to 1. So if we take from the formula of arc length in parametric equation or parametric function, then we have the s is actually the integral from alpha beta, the square root of this one. This one is actually to this equal to this one. So the formula become s is equal to the integral alpha beta square root of r square plus dr d theta square d theta, where the r is equal to f theta. So this is the formula of the arc length in polar coordinate. So that's all. This is the theorem. This statement is just saying the same formula as before. I mean this formula. And let's go to the example. In this example, I take it from the book of Sullivan. We want to find the length of the logarithmic spiral function. R is equal to f theta is equal to a power 3 times theta. From theta is equal to 0 until 2. The solution is just by using this formula. Because the R is equal to a power 3 times theta, then the dr dt is equal to 3a power 3 theta. And of course, it is automatically the s is equal to the integral from 0 to 2 of the square root of the r square. The r is actually equal to a to power theta, a power 3 theta square, 3 a power 3 theta square. So altogether, we have this integral. And this is equal to this integral. It is very easy to calculate that the arc length of the logarithmic spiral function, this function, is equal to the square of the 10, square of 10 divided by 3 times a power 6 minus 1. So even though this number is not good number, but we can easily understand that this limit can be done for computing the arc length of this logarithmic spiral function. This is the first example. The second example may be from our lecture note, diktat in Indonesian language is diktat, it is in English is lecture note. For instance, we want to calculate the k from the parametric function r is equal to r cos theta, y is equal to r sin theta, and then we can calculate by using the same way as before. Then we have the same formula. But this is from the diktat. So I don't want to go it in detail because it is the same idea as in the book of Sullivan. Let's go to our example. We want to we want to find the arc length of the cardioid. R is equal to 1 plus cos theta. The theta between 0 and 2 phi. The curve is this one, the blue curve. So we want to calculate the length of this curve. Because the R is a function of theta, the R F is equal to F theta, equal to 1 plus cos theta, then we have that the dr theta is equal to minus sin theta, and the dr theta square is equal to sin square theta. So R square plus dr d theta square is equal to 1 plus 2 cos theta plus cos quadrat theta plus sin theta quadrat. Because this expression is equal to 1, so this is 1 plus 1, so become 2. 2 plus 2 cos theta. Okay? As we have the formula in calculus 1, then it is equal to 4 cos square 1 over 2 theta. So the S is actually the integral between 0 until 2 phi, that is one round, until 2 phi, of this square, yeah, of R square plus dr d theta square. So this is very easy because this is equal to sin square theta. Because this equal to sin square theta, and the R theta is actually equal to 1 plus cos theta square. This is, so altogether we have R square is equal to this one. So by taking the square, we have the square of 4 is 2, the square of cos square is cos. So we have the 2 cos 1 over 2 theta d theta. So it is equal to 8. It is equal to 8. So if we take this, the conclusion is that the cardioid R is equal to 1 plus cos theta. This is the unit cardioid, and the length of the curve of the cardioid is equal to 8. Thirdly, is the example from asteroid. As you see here, the asteroid is just like this. X power through divided by 3 plus y divided power 2 divided by 3 is equal to a power 3 divided 2 divided by 3. If we write in, if we write this formula in parametric coordinate, in parametric equation or parametric function, it becomes the x is equal to r cos to the power of 3t, a sin t to the power of 3t. It come from the calculus 1, or we already know. And then we want to count the length. The length is actually the following. We take the dx dt from this is equal to 3 times a cos square 2 times the derivative of cos, it is minus sin t. The dy dt is just the same way, 3a sin square 3 times the derivative of sin, that is cos t. If we take this, this square is equal to this square, yeah, and then the dy dt d theta square is just equal to this square, and all together we add all together, we have the 9a square sin square theta cos theta, and finally we have the square of this one, that is the square of 9 is equal to 3, square of a square is a, sin square, the square of sin square is sin, and so on. So altogether we have the 4 times, 4 times from 0 till 5 divided by 2 of the square of this one, that is the 3a sin theta cos theta. This is very easy by using the definite integral.